I first met Ben when he gave a talk in church, and he was standing up there in his little suspenders. He was 14 years old. It was the summer before our freshman year in high school. And he was giving a talk, and I still remember what it was about. It was about faith, and I thought he was so cute. And I was sitting down there just thinking how cute he was, and I wanted to go introduce myself to him.
Okay, I first met Debbie. We moved into a new house. My family did, and so we started going to a new church building, and when we got there, when you're new in the ward, they usually have your family give a talk and kind of introduce yourself. So I gave a talk, and she came up to me after the talk, and she just kind of introduced herself, said hi, and said she was Debbie, which I already knew because I saw her school, because she was a cheerleader and everybody knew Debbie. So she came up and she just introduced herself and asked me if I knew where my next class was, which I didn't, so she took me to the next class. And
I went and I introduced myself to him and told him my name was Debbie, and I asked him if he knew where his class was, and he didn't, so I walked him to his class, showed him where it was.
That's how we first kind of met. That was the first time I ever really saw Debbie. I remember a few weeks later, we got to church, and we got there a few minutes late, which we always do, and we got there late, and we were standing out in the foyer just kind of waiting, and her family got there late too, so she came up and said hi, and we were talking, and I'd already told my parents about her, like, Debbie Jewel's in our ward, and I just thought she had the most amazing smile, like amazing, and so I remember telling my dad, just, you know, like, she came up and she was like, hi, man, and we talked for a second, and then I turned around and I remember saying to my dad, did you see her smile? she always looks good.
Later on, I asked him if he wanted to go to a dance with a bunch of my friends, and we went to a church dance.
She asked me if I had a dance card, and I didn't, and so she said that I had to call the bishop. And it was like 4 or 5 o'clock when she called, and the dance starts at 7 or 7:30, so I called the bishop, and I was like, Bishop. It was Bishop Johnson. I said, I need a card to go to the steak dance. It's an emergency. I was like, it's tonight and I have to have one to go. And he's like, well, why is it an emergency? And I said, because Debbie Jewel just called me. And she asked if I want to go, and I want to go, and I don't have a card. And so he said, well, that's an emergency, so come over. So I went over and I got the card, and I went back to my house, and I was getting all ready, trying to, you know, look good. And
I remember when we went to go pick him up, my mom was driving because we were only 14. And as soon as we pulled up, he came booking out of the house, and I was like, what is wrong with this kid? And he came running out as fast as he could, and he's like, go, go, go. And so my mom opened the door, he opened the door, and he just booked it inside the car.
My brother just thoroughly enjoys embarrassing people. Like, it's his greatest habit or greatest desire. And so he decided that he was gonna embarrass us. So I knew he would do it, and he was waiting for it to come, and I remember he was in the kitchen, my mom was like getting stuff ready, and Debbie's mom pulled up and she honked, and so I quietly tried to slip out the door, and I remember I was coming out the door and he turned and he's like, Ben, where are you going? And so I booked it, I went running for the car as fast as I could because I knew he was gonna come, and I tried to jump in the car and he came out and started doing his embarrassing, he just says stuff that's embarrassing, even if you've never said it, he just says, oh, you know, she didn't have a mustache, or, you know, something stupid, like as if you had said that when you didn't.
His older brother came running out as fast as he could after him, and just started tormenting poor Ben, and Ben is trying not to die, you know, it's just embarrassing him in front of this girl, me, and so we thought that was hilarious. We went to the dance, and I got a dance with Ben, and he was a very good dancer.
I remember a few weeks later, we went to a play or something like that, and she asked me to hold her money. And so I did, and I went home, and after the play, and I was getting undressed, and I was emptying out my pockets, and I still had her money. So I threw back on my clothes and some cologne, and I went down to her house, and I just knocked on the door, and she came out, and I gave her money back, and we just sat there on her front porch and talked for hours. And I don't know, we just talked for forever, and that was how it kind of all started from there. We just became really good friends.
In high school, it's about the sophomore year in high school, I hurt my knee really bad in cheerleading. And I was on crutches, and Ben came over to take care of me, and he made me dinner, and it was so sweet. And I remember he was just teasing me, and he decided he was gonna run into my room and read my journal. At least that's what he told me. He's like, I'm going in your room to read your journal. And I freaked out, of course, because it's my most personal feelings in there. And so he goes running in there and slams the door and locks it. And so I get up and I'm freaking out, and I get my crutches, and crutch all the way to my room, and I'm all sweaty and because I'm sick, you know, and my knee hurts, and he's just teasing me. And he comes out and he sees me, he's like, "You're not supposed to get up." And so he carries me back and lays me down, and I was all sweaty, and it was so cute because he kissed my forehead, and it was such a sweet moment. And I knew then that he was my best friend, and I knew that I would always be happy with him and he would always take care of me.
I think we just always kind of knew that we were gonna get married. We always knew that there was something special between us. I remember one time I was driving with my dad in a car, and ever since we met, our families just kind of grew together. Our parents became, my mom and her mom just became best friends, and we always did family things together, family camping trips and that kind of stuff. And I remember one time I was driving with my dad in the car, and he says to me, we were going by her house, we weren't going there, we were going someplace else, but we passed her house, and he said, "You know, it's too bad that you didn't meet Debbie later." And I said, "Why is that?" And he said, "Because she's a really special girl." And he said, "There's, you know, the chances of you two making it all the way to get married are slim to none, but I wish you would have met her later." But we made it.
Then when he went to go get the ring, he had told me that he wasn't going to be able to afford one until February, and I was fine. And I was searching around on his desk just seeing what was up, and I found this receipt from Diamond Consortium. I picked it up and I looked at it, and I looked at it briefly and I saw Diamond Consortium on top. I said, "Oh no," and I put it back down. I didn't want to look at it right then. And I went back to work and I told all my friends about it, that I had seen it, and they're like, "Go back and look at it." And so I went back the next day when he wasn't there, and I memorized it, and I was being devious, and I went back and I memorized it, and I went back to work and I told everyone about it.
I got home for my mission and I started getting together everything with the ring, and I got the ring. I got it on the 12th. I got it in the evening, and I told her I was going to go out with the missionaries for a few minutes and go do some exchanges. And I went over and I got the ring, and I remember I brought it home and I showed it to everyone, and everyone was all excited because everyone knew I was going to get it, and I thought she didn't know I had it, which apparently she did. I didn't find that out till later, but I thought she didn't know that I was getting it yet, because I had told her it was going to be several months before I'd be able to get it. So I remember I went over to her house, and her mom left to go do something else, you know, supposedly, but she really went over to my house and checked out the ring, and I was just so excited to give it to her. I had all these plans of how I was going to do it with my family, and I'd been talking for weeks about different ideas of how I was going to give it to her so that everyone could be there. And
then we all started analyzing how he was going to ask me. We all started analyzing every move he made and everything he said. We would all talk about it, trying to figure out how he was going to ask me, you know, and what I was going to say, and I had everything planned out about what I was going to say. And of course, when he did ask me, I didn't say what I was going to say.
I just got too excited. I couldn't give it to her, and I took the ring to work, and everybody at work was all excited, and they were getting me all pumped up. And so I finally just emailed her mom and told her that I was going to give it to her. I was going to give it to her that night. And so we went, and we were driving to my brother's house.
We were going to Ben's brother's house, and his hands were clammy, and I thought that was weird, because I wasn't expecting the ring to arrive for another day, according to the receipt. And his hands were clammy and he was acting nervous, and I just thought maybe he was nervous about something that happened that day or something he was thinking about. And he said, and he was joking around, and he's like, "So you want to get married?" And he always did that, and I always said, "Hey, you can't ask me unless you have a ring."
I stopped in this park and we were walking around just kind of talking, and I asked her, I said, "So you want to get married or what?" And she was like, "Don't say that until you're serious." And I remember I was so nervous. I don't know why I was nervous. I was pretty sure she was going to say yes, but I just knelt down and I took out the ring and I said, "Debbie Jewel, will you be my wife?" And she cried. I remember she cried a lot because I gave her the ring and she put it on, and it fit because I'd had her finger size before. I knew what her size was. And we went over and we sat down and she cried, and we just talked for a few minutes, and it was a special moment, a special time for us.
So we went for a walk when we got to his brother's house. So we went for a walk and we found a park. We were just talking, and he was all nervous, and I didn't know why he was nervous, because according to the receipt, the ring wouldn't arrive for a couple days. And of course I felt bad that I knew about the ring, but I told him about it later so I'd feel better. And then he asked me again, so you want to get married? And I said, Ben, you can't ask me that unless you're serious and you have the ring, because I won't be able to take you seriously when you really do have the ring. And he's like, well, what if I am serious? And so I kind of got a little nervous, and he got down on one knee, and I was so nervous, I didn't know what to think. I didn't know if this was serious or if this was, if this is real or not, because I didn't think the ring would arrive for another day. And he pulled out the ring, and it was gorgeous, and I was so happy. And I've always known that I would say yes. I wanted to say, oh, I'd love to, yes, but I didn't. I just kind of cried, and he took that as a yes, and I was so excited.
I just want you to know, Debbie, that I love you, and that I look forward to the time we have to spend together. I look forward to the rest of our lives. Somebody that I respect and that I look up to. The last 6 years have been fun. We've grown together. I think we've established a relationship on friendship more than anything as we grew up together. And I think it'll be a base for us that we'll build off of the rest of our lives. I look forward to the time when we'll be able to have a family and try and teach them the things that are right. I love you, and I'm grateful for what you do, for the example you are for me. And I hope that we can always keep the love that we have now forever and make it grow. And a thousand sensations seduce me, cause I do cherish you for the rest of my life. You don't have to think twice. I will love you still from the depths of my soul. It's beyond my control. I waited so long to say this to you. If you're asking, do I love you this much? Well, I do.
Ben, I love you so much, and I feel so blessed that you have chosen to marry me. Sometimes I can't believe that out of all the people in the world, you chose me to marry you. I look so forward to our lives together. I know that we're going to be so happy, and I'm so lucky that I get to marry my best friend. And I love you so dearly, and I know that you will do anything you can to help me and help me make me happy, and I will try the rest of my life to make you as happy as you made me. And I just can't wait for every moment I can spend with you and all your little kisses. And I love you dearly.
To let me shine.